Today is Thursday, and that of course means we are back in nutrition educator Lynn Matava's kitchen. Today, Lynn shows us how to make the perfect side dish using squash. Check it out.
Good morning, and it is a good morning because today I am standing here with a delicata squash, which is one of my favorite winter finds to find at a farmer's market this weekend. This is a squash that it does, as I said before, it overwinters well. So you may still find them if you drop by one of your local farmers. What really makes these special, in my opinion, is that unlike a lot of the winter squashes that have tough skins, you can actually eat the skin on this one. So, you know, it's all in the name, delicata. It's a very delicate and very delicious squash. It also, in my opinion, it's very buttery. Like, it really tastes like it's got a whole bunch of butter mixed in with it, even when it doesn't, which I think is a really great thing when we can eat something that's healthy for us that also gives us that really pleasant mouthfeel. So I've gone ahead and washed this one today, and all I'm going to do is slice it in half lengthwise. And you can see that reveals all of those the seeds inside. You could just discard them. I'm going to save them because they also are little nutrient powerhouses, and they're also delicious. So I'm gonna set them aside to clean for later. A little bit stringy, so I am going to I'm just using my knife just to very slightly get some of those strings out. Okay. Let's push those off to the side. They'll be rinsed, and I'll probably put them in a pan later. And then I'm just gonna slice these in probably about half to 3/4 inch thick pieces. Such a bright and pretty thing, and then even when they go in this pan, they kind of look like they're smiling at me. Just a great thing, first thing in the morning here. And I'm arranging them in a pan that can go into the oven. Personally, my favorite way to cook these, I actually will just hit them with a knife or a fork a few times like you would a potato, and I cook them whole. You could either roast them in the oven or even just put them in the microwave until they're soft, and then kind of take all the insides out. I really like them pureed because I feel like they are just so buttery, and it just makes a really nice accompaniment to like a hearty meat, like a chop or something like that, a pork chop. This is another fun recipe because you can eat the skin. So I just wanted to show you how easy this is. And I'm just throwing them in here like this. This recipe comes from the Maryland Eat Smart, our Eat Smart SnapEd website. So you can go look that up there, or you can just follow along here. And then I'm just going to add in a little bit of red onion. They're pretty, they give it a nice bit of flavor, some aromatics. And see, I just slice them, you know, just a little bit, not a ton, throwing that on top. And then we are just going to drizzle it very lightly in a little bit of oil. I'm using olive oil. You could use the cooking oil of your choice. And then I'm gonna put a little bit of pepper, and I'm going to add a little bit of salt. You could do this to your liking. Don't need much though. And like some of the squashes that are sweeter, I don't find this one to be very sweet. This one is more on the, like I said, buttery, savory side, which is why I threw in those onions. And then they're gonna go into a 400 degree oven for about, the recipe says 30 to 35 minutes. To be honest, I like them after about 15. So they don't need to go in for terribly long. And I've got one that I sliced up this morning and cooked before we came on, so you can see it. And It's so pretty. You could throw a little bit of green, the little pepita pumpkin seeds to give it some color, or even some chopped up salad greens would go really pretty in there. And I'm actually going to cook the seeds after I've cleaned those, cook them all together, and sprinkle them into it. It's just gonna make a really fun side dish for the to enjoy. So I really hope you get out there and find some of these because they really, really are an exciting and delicious offering here on the shore this time of year. Enjoy.
Now, as a reminder, we do have all of Lynn's tips and tricks on our website. To find them, just log on to 47abc.com and then click on the Good Morning Delmarva page.